Why, it's Tina here, Total Rock, with the marvelous Rachel from Skid Row.
Oh, marvelous. I've never been called marvelous before.
Really?
Ever.
Well, I personally think you're marvelous.
Oh,
so there
thank you.
Go.
Well, I think you're marvelous, too.
Oh, well, this is a lovely society of
marvelousness. I still
think we should see other people. Let's do that. So, Skid Row, you're headlining the very first Stonedeaf Festival. How does that feel?
It feels pretty damn good, I got to admit, man. That they have faith in us to put us on their very, very first show. And so far, it's just been such a great day. And I think this is going to be around a long time, Stonedeaf. And the idea is great, just a one-day festival, in and out, nice quick punch. And I think it's going to be around for a really long time. And we're really excited.
Well, I mean, there have been so many people saying that this is such a marvelous festival. The atmosphere, the way it's been organized, everything's brilliant. So you echo those thoughts too?
Yeah, I agree 100%. And like the lineup's really cool with Anvil, Choir Boys, and Graham Bonnet. I mean, come on, you know. And it's so old school that it just feels really good and seeing everyone out there with battle vests and. Yeah, it's cool. A festival doesn't have to take over a whole town, you know what I mean? There's going to be a few thousand people here that are going to be having so much fun tonight. And since we rolled in this morning, man, we've just been really excited. We're like, 9 o'clock yet? 9 o'clock yet? Or whatever time we go on, you know? So.
Well, I think it's brilliant. I've heard everyone go, oh, Skid Row just arrived, Skid Row just arrived. And there was a big buzz that you were here last night. Everyone was like, oh, are they here? Are they here?
When did we get here? I think we got here early this morning.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what time. We were in Wolverhampton last night at KKs Steel Mill, which was another first. We were the first national play there and got to hang out with KK, which is awesome, you know.
It's brilliant what he's doing because he really wants to make sure that, you know, there is a place for live music because there aren't that many venues anymore. They're dying a death.
I heard that two of them will be closed for like almost 3 years for renovation. So it's a big place. And it was, again, like... they're new, but they know what they're doing because KK is like, okay, and it caters to the artist and to the bands because KK has seen it all, you know. It just wanted to make sure that everything was cool, and it's going to be great, man. It's going to be really good, so I suggest any band going through there to play it.
Stop off.
Yeah,
stop off on the way.
Hell yeah.
Now, tell me, what have we got to look forward to tonight?
You know, just like a typical Skid Row show. Lots of energy. You're going to hear every song that you expect, and... it's gonna be an assault, man.
Well, we last saw you, Shepherd's Bush, and that was a marvelous, and that's the first time seeing it, ZP as well. So he seems to have brought an extra dimension to the band.
He really has. You know, he's a very talented singer and a great front man, and it's funny when he first came over to the States. To sing, and we were just all getting together because him and I and Rob had been friends for a few years at that point. But when he first came over to sing, it was so like effortless. He's 10 years younger than us, and he kind of grew up listening to us, you know. And when he's from South Africa, and him and his friends had to sneak and play our records because they were deemed offensive, which is really funny. Yeah, he came over and he was more than prepared and just blew us away. And then when we, we toured for a year together, and when it was official, our stock went up and everything started getting better and better. And he brought this excitement to the band that we haven't had for quite some time. And now we just can't wait to get out on stage every night. And it's like, if we're off for a couple of days, it's like, when we get back out there, it's so much fun, you know.
And there's a lot of energy, a lot of fun. It's brilliant going to see a Skid Row show. And it's going to be brilliant on the Monsters of Rock cruise next year, right?
Yeah, it's pretty wild. They've been asking us to do it for a while, and we're going to go out there and do a show on the cruise. So, you know, a lot of bands, man. We've done cruises before. We've done a few Kiss cruises, and we did... Shiprock. Yeah, we did Shiprock. We did the one that goes from Stockholm to Helsinki and back. One was like a Radio Classiker, and then there was another one that we did. There's just a 24-hour cruise, and those are fun. We've just always been on the road for the Monsters of Rock cruise, and this, next year, 2019, they nailed us down to do it. So, we're going to go out there and do a show on the high seas. It'll be cool.
That will definitely be cool. Yeah. I mean, it's a... It's a lot of fun on there. I've done three of them.
Oh, have you? Yeah, I've never been on
one. My liver hasn't still not forgiven me,
that's
but
what
everybody it's well
says.
Worth it.
Yeah.
It's great because actually, I think once, and it feels like the same as this festival, is that actually there's no division between the bands and the fans.
Right.
So everyone just hangs out. Everyone, you know, you guys were watching Acid Wagons just before you came over here,
yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, it's everyone just gets together and enjoys the music.
Right, yeah. That's a cool thing about cruises is that you really, you get on such a personal level with the people that like your band more than, excuse me, I have a cat hair in my mouth, or the dog hair, maybe.
That's good. It's the cat then.
Yeah, it's a cat.
I can see a dog, but no
yeah,
cat.
So because you see them every day at breakfast and every day at the bar, so you start learning names and like, hey, what are you doing later, man? We're going to go out to this, you know, and when we get off of Mexico, we're going to whatever, you know, and you end up hanging out. And sometimes you make really good friends, you know.
I can remember Ted Poley, actually, and we started having a conversation about tuxedo cats, talking about cats, because
yeah.
We both love tuxedo cats. So,
oh, yeah.
And
one.
We became, yeah, do you?
Yeah, I got two cats.
Good. Mine's called Tommy Lee.
Oh, okay. I got Clarence and Lovey.
Nice. Well, we'll always talk about cats.
Yeah.
But we probably shouldn't talk about cats, because I'm sure the fans want to hear about you. What's next, then?
I like
today?
Cats.
I like cats, too.
Tonight is our last show on this UK run, and we go home for... we got 9 days off, which is long for us this year. And we have a few shows in the States, and then we're going to Minsk in Belarus to do a festival there. Well, not really a festival. It's in an arena there that we're headlining. We've never even been there before. So it's a lot of firsts this year, you know. And we're doing that and flying back to the States and continuing our U.S. tour. And in between all that, we're trying to get in and get this record finished, you know, because we're working with Michael Wagner, who did our first two records, and we started pre-production, but it's we're so damn busy this year that we have to do it in pieces, which is actually making me a nervous wreck because I like getting in there and getting it done. I think it's getting all of us a little tense, but, you know, we're writing still. Snake and I are just writing like crazy, man, and just getting into rehearsals.
So you're getting lots of inspiration from the road?
Sometimes I do. I get more from just being like, I'm a listener, and like I pick up when I'm out personally and I'll hear someone having a conversation online in a supermarket or something. I'll be like, what did they say? And, you know, headlines and whatever. So I don't really have one specific place I grab it from, but, you know, like we always do, we get in and we talk for an hour or so, and hey, I got this riff, and then we talk, and then just stuff just starts falling together, you know.
Well, this is brilliant, and I think you're going to be on stage very, very soon.
Yeah.
Between now and then, how do you prepare for a show like this?
I'll probably just chill in the bus, maybe watch a movie, or I just started getting into Game of Thrones, so we have every season on the bus, and I'm like, wow, this is some good gore and. In one episode, I saw three beheadings. What else was there? I don't know, disemboweling and incest. I'm like, wow, this is an awesome show.
Learning a lot about Rachel.
No, I just started watching. And I was like, wow, now I know. It just kind of sucks you in. You're like, okay, horse gets his head chopped off. That guy was pretty angry.
Okay, I think he was. Well, I tell you what, I'll let you go and see some more, I don't know, incest.
Just for the record, I would never support cutting a horse's head off.
Good. I'm glad you said that. I'm sure our fans are as well.
I love animals.
I love animals too. Yeah. So, Rachel, go and have a great set. Can't wait.
Thank you.
And enjoy the rest of Stonedeaf.
Thanks. We're very excited. Thanks for having me.